Welcome back to HBI Guys Workshop. It's Chris here. We're going to be building a new kit today, doing a full review of Revell's re-release of the M4 Sherman tank. This model kit is older than I am, and I've been around for a long time. So it's in 1/35th scale. It's a skill level 4 for 12 and up. Now it does have the making the Black Magic Sherman. I'm not sure if I'm going to make it with that exact logo, but I am going to assemble the tank and make it look like a World War II Sherman tank. Let's take a look at everything that's in the box. First up is going to be the manual. It's all very straightforward. It's like 8 pages, 6 steps. Numerous parts go on each step, but the exploded view is absolutely enormous. Makes everything very easy. There's less than 100 parts total in the kit. Everything except the tracks is molded in this nice green color, but that doesn't matter to me because I'm going to be priming it black for shadows. Then I'll be painting it olive drab. Here are your side skirts. You can see that they've got the extra tracks molded right on top. Like I said, this is an older style kit, so you got to give it a break. Don't be so critical. It's still going to come out looking like a nice M4 Sherman. I promise you. So you can see the side skirts, they're very shiny. So we're definitely going to want to prime this so the paint sticks. You can see that's the bottom of the hull. And we'll get out some more green plastic. This stuff, there's a lot of loose parts in the box. They bag them, and it's all in one bag. So I do have a little bag rash. It does come with 3 figures. This is one of them. Now, I won't be using him because this isn't going to be a diorama. This is just going to be the tank itself. So I will save him because he's not a bad figure. And you've seen me build other dioramas, so you know that I can use them. The second figure out of the 3 is another individual that would be sitting out on his own outside the tank. So I won't be using him, but I will be saving him. We've got the 50 cal machine gun. We've got numerous hooks and equipment holders. Very small parts there, so take it easy. We've got our road wheels with the tires attached and our drive sprockets. And these wheels are on the other side, on the inside, that you cannot see, so they did not detail them. But the road wheels that you can see are fairly detailed and will come out once they're painted green. The tires are painted and it's given a wash. You can see that. You can see the other side of those wheels and the idler. The other idler has fallen off, but that's okay. I still have it. It didn't run away. This is the only figure out of the kit I will be using, which would be the tank commander. He's got a nice set of goggles there. You can see him. Hello. I'm going to go fight in Britain. Next up, we got some more parts over here in green. Get them out here. We've got our very simplified suspension system, all one piece. The wheels just attached to them. So that shouldn't be hard. Pick that out with a wash. This isn't going to be a super detailed build. This is going to be a nice, simple, one-day construction. I'm going to try to get it all done in one day. If I don't, I'll let you know as the review goes on if I've expanded it into more than one day. We've got our hatches, we've got more idlers and road wheels and wheel backs. The mantlet is in 2 pieces. That's actually the mantlet on the turret and our hatch. Up last will be upper hull, turret, transmission cover, and this little part here goes on the back. It did have some box rash, one of those tiny little clips did break off, so I'm not going to be showing it too much till I start working. I've got to glue that back on and just let it sit and chill out. I can fix that easily. Transmission cover for the front end. That's your front armor as well, of course. Turret. The turret has no bottom to it. If you want to give it that cast look, if you wanted to go that far, rub your cement all over it and stipple it with a really stiff paintbrush, and that'll give you that cast turret look. The vision blocks, of course, will just be washed in. There is no glass for those. There is no glass in any of the kit. Here's the top of the hull. Now, this kit only runs about $20, so that's why you're going to be a little short on details, but it still looks just like a Sherman. Got our braces molded in. Don't cut these off. Those hold up your fenders. So we got nice detail on the back. The tools are molded in. So just get out the small paint brushes and pick them out and then wash around them, and that'll highlight each one lovely. No problem at all. Now the turret does fit right like so, and it actually fits in nice and tight, so there won't be an issue. We're not going to have any problems. Now I need to run this over to the parts washing area. I'm going to start working. While I'm doing that, we'll get one last look at the vinyl tracks. It's a big rubber band track. You get two of them. It just snap locks together. I kind of like rubber band tracks because they're super easy to paint and detail, and we'll go over that. And then you can put these on the model after it's all assembled and ready to go. You don't have to work around them and paint around them. You can get these all painted and weathered up and ready to go. I'm going to start washing everything off. We got some decals to go on. I'm going to be cutting those stars out all on their own, and I'm not going to be using the Black Magic. But the rest I'll be using. I'll see you as soon as the parts are washed, and I've got some sub-assemblies done and ready for paint. Be right back. About an hour into assembly, things going together just fine. The fit seems just fine. I haven't had any issues at all. I think they must have cleaned up the molds or something. There hasn't been any big flash to worry about. I've got the hull bottom, which is three pieces assembled with the axles in. You can see the front axle, the rear axle. So I'm almost wondering back in the day if these two parts here didn't help motorize this kit somehow. A little tip, since it is a three-piece hull, you might be worried about alignment. Now, it's going to line up with a little key in the very bottom here. Just a little one right there. You can see the two little tabs come together. And then it pushes up flat against the rear, or the radiator, the grill exhaust area of the Sherman. That will pretty much get you perfectly straight. But to ensure that it's perfectly straight, there are six pins total on the top of the skirts, the fenders. The body has six nice large locating holes in it as well. So just snap that on, friction fit it on. You can see that I've done it straight now, so now it fits. And let that go over and dry. Now don't glue this on, but put it on there, set this off to the side, and you can be assured that your side skirts will be perfectly up and down. The bottom of the hull will be perfectly square, and you don't have to worry about it. You can set it on the side. While it's drying, you can go along and lay more glue into that seam down there, which just melts away with a quality solvent glue. And then you can reach inside the hull and wick more glue inside there. They have you assemble the turret first. I've got the mantlet on. The mantlet still moves. You can see I put my fingerprint right in the glue there when I was pushing it together, but that's okay. I sand it off. 5 minutes later, it'll be just fine. They have you put on the little rack back here, the 50 cal mount, the spotlight, and a hook, and two more hook attachments right there on the back of the turret. That's as far as I went with that. I didn't attach anything else to it because I want to be able to paint it first. On the top of the hull, by step number three, they want you to start filling these holes with headlights, grab handles, tail lights in the back, accessory parts. I'm not doing any of that now. That will get painted separately, and those will get attached just before I'm done with the tank. I'm going to be flipping this tank over, working on it, messing with it, painting it, attaching suspension, attaching tracks. I don't want to break anything off. So I'm going to continue working on the sub-assemblies. Next up is doing all the road wheels and putting those on the hull. And then after that is pretty much they want you to start doing final assembly. So once I get those road wheels on and everything, we're going to be taking this over and getting it shot up with some paint. See you in a bit. We're over in my painting area now, and I'm going to be airbrushing this time, something we don't do a lot of on the channel because normally I can find the spray paints that I want to use, but I don't have any good greens, and I wanted to use this English U green from Ceramcoat as my green color. Now, I've already done the bottom of the hull, and I've just mixed that craft paint with windshield washer, the cheap blue stuff, at about a 60-40 ratio, 60% paint, 40% windshield washer. So let me reach over and turn my compressor on, and I've got it running at about 15 PSI, and I'm just going to start laying a coat. Now, it's going to come out real thin at first, and then you'll start slowly building up your layers. Now, it's a flat paint, and it's a craft paint, so it will self-level, and I'll just keep putting those coats on there. So this is going to be good enough for the first coat. You can see that black primer has already developed those nice shadows. So I'll just keep working on this, and we'll be back when I am all done painting. Plugging along in my automobile or my M4 Sherman tank. What I've got it done so far is I've painted the road wheels, assembled the suspension, and attached everything. They just push on, and that's how I'm going to leave them so I can get the tracks on later. I've painted the tools that are on the back of the vehicle. Those are molded in, so just get out your really fine brushes. Remember not to paint the straps so it looks like they're being held down by something. The tank is nice and shiny right now. I've given it a coat of gloss clear for the next steps that are coming up. Once the gloss clear is completely hardened up for me, then I'm going to go ahead and start giving it pin washes, cleaning it out. I'm going to be able then on the gloss coat to attach those decals that I want to use. Once those are all dry, then I'll just give the decals a quick shot of clear over the top, go in, start doing some more washing, pin washing, adding some dirt effects. I'm not going to totally mud this thing up, but I am going to make it look nice. The turret, you're supposed to attach it numerous steps ago, but it will sit in there perfectly. There's no reason to attach it. You can still turn it, and I can remove it for decaling weathering. Up after that, I've got to get these tracks weathered. I'm going to be using some craft paints. I've already sprayed them flat black so it takes the gloss off, and then I shot them with flat clear to seal it all in so it didn't chip off the vinyl. Then I'm going to start filling those in with mud and goo, just enough so you can tell it's been used and some dust effects. And when I get done getting the decals on and doing a little pin washing, we'll be back. As you can clearly see, I've gone quite a ways here. I've metallicized the extra track links. I've muddied and painted the tracks. Now they look really stark now, so don't freak out, think it's all ruined. No matter how new the tank is, the tracks are going to get dirty. The first time they drive across a parade field or anything like that, they're going to get full of mud. This would have been used in the European theater, so it's going to get dirty immediately. But what I did was, you can see I got the decals on. I did them differently what the manual did. I wanted to put the identification number and the U.S. Army logo on the back. On the turret, we've got the identification number. We've got 3 stars on the turret like they would have wanted to have them. On the sides and on the top for overhead so they don't get bombed. And then the classic star right on top of the transmission cover on the front of the armor. Then the identification number on the side. That was the only decals that I used in the kit. I gloss coated over those decals so that I can start painting and weathering. The tracks are attached. They went on just fine. What I did to start painting the tracks, it's a mixture of, first, I shoot the black tracks with some Tamiya bright gunmetal. Let that dry. Then I coat them with burnt sienna to give them the rust tone. Then I coat them with gloss brown to give them the mud in the middle of the tracks. Then I sand them down a little bit with a sanding stick while they're laying flat. Then after I attach them to the tank, I go in with a silver paint pen and I touch areas where it's going to be bare metal. Now it's super bright right now. It's going to darken up. I'm going to start applying some panel lines to the whole tank. Panel line wash and Tamiya's black. That will give me my pin washes and accent areas on the tank. Then I will be taking some mud-colored paint and some tile grout as well that I don't have out here yet and flick it into the road wheels, into the suspension, a little bit on the hull, but it's mainly going to be a pretty clean hull. Just from driving it around, they haven't seen any heavy action yet. I did drill out the barrel. I don't know if I showed you that before, so I didn't want to show you. With a 1 millimeter drill bit, I drilled down about 1/2 inch, so it looks a lot better than just a plain slug on the end there. I've still got to paint the driver figure. I've already painted the 50 cal, but I'm not attaching that. I've got the tail lights, the headlights, and the guards to go on. Those are going to go on the very last point, just before I start flicking some dirt and mud on there, because I don't want to break anything off while I'm messing with pin washes and flipping the tank and rolling it over. So I'm going to start applying that weathering. TV came back on for a second. I'm going to start applying that weathering, and we'll be back once you can see how that wash and some of the weathering's looking. Welcome back for the final. So what do you guys think? What I did was I went through and I added some tile grout for the dirt effects. Now, what I wanted this to simulate was a tank that was relatively new, had been used, but I don't, my personal style isn't to weather them up like they're all beaten to heck. I like to weather them up and wash them just so that they look used, but not used up. So this is my interpretation of what a nice Sherman would take. You know, it's seen some combat. It's got some stains on the barrel from firing. So the barrel is darkened. It's got some mud, which it would get anywhere just going down a regular old muddy road. But it's not completely chipped up, rusted up, beat up. It's still taken care of. Probably comes out of headquarters, does some missions. I didn't want to add the black magic decals. I figure people have been putting those on. since 1955, which is what I found out was the original release for this kit. So I just used the numbers and the callouts, the American stars, the nameplates on the back of the fenders, and whatnot. Now I used that Tamiya weathering wash, that panel line wash, to accentuate things, and we're going to go for a little bit of a ride here so that you can see. That's a real fun product. If you don't have time to make a wash, you can see it sinks into the grills. It goes around the tools. It goes around the fuel cans. It goes up on the turret, and anywhere you want to have a shadow or a line, it'll stand out real nice and look nice. Now, this kit runs $20 anywhere. It's available. It's been re-released this year. The Revell checked on the molds. The copyright on the mold now is 2017, and it all looks spiffy. Now, I did not use the other two figures. They could always be used in something else. I chose not to use them, but I did use the TC because he looks awesome in that hatch. Gives you a sense of scale. I got his goggles painted up. So I think it turned out real nice. I enjoyed it. It was definitely worth the purchase price compared to some other tanks out there that I've reviewed that haven't had a chance to build yet, where they're $50, $60, almost $100, and it's just a lot of fun. Now, I gave it a little bit of a dull coat at the end. Even though these tanks were kind of shiny, they weren't glossy like I had it to apply the decals and do the weathering. So I did just give it an overspray with a little bit of flat matte and a seal. That mud in there, the dirt, that's just a can of tile grout mixed gently with just a little bit of water, and make it stick and brush it in and glop it on, and it'll stick wherever it would stick on the real thing. So overall, I like it. I think you'll like it. Go pick it up. Right now, like I said, they're only about $20. I got mine from Tower Hobbies, one of my favorite places to get model kits. So it turned out real well with craft paints. We showed you some airbrushing, panel line washes, how to add mud just using tile grout, how to do tank tracks, make them look a little realistic. Hope you liked it. We'll see you at the next review.